the 80s, pops drove a Mercedes. Did a big coming home to some grown ass kid. Crack baby turn a young thug, description might fit you. Look around, it might hit you. No joke, don't want a pistol fight with you. Shit comes around faster than you think. Blood and white chalk make pink, so what's that make you? Become a creature of habitat. The average cat won't see where it's at or where it's going.
It's always a pleasure to come back to Howard and talk to students. I love this place, and I'm always talking about this place, and this place kind of set the standard for me as to what I thought students should be doing. And I realized since then that a lot of students in other places are really not getting the richness that I think a lot of Howard students get. And I came up under a lot of the old faculty, Ed Love, Skunda, Jeff, and realized that I took a lot of things with me that are very important that I see the students are not getting elsewhere. So I think it's important for alumni to come back and share with you what's happening in the real world in terms of art. I primarily specialize in large-scale monumental sculpture, and I do public art. And so what James has asked me to do is to show some of my slides, and more importantly, talk about some of the things related to public art. And I understand you guys have had a number of artists come through. I know Martha has been through, Keely Ryan, so a number of people who were my contemporaries and who I admire. So that what I would like to do, while just familiarizing you with some of my images, is answer any questions that I can regarding public art. What you as students, those are your students, should be doing with anybody I think who comes to a class like this, a very valuable class like this, is picking the brain of artists just like you pick the brain of faculty. You need to be getting information, anything. So anything that you want to ask, no matter how simplistic you think or how basic, you need to ask. The idea is to get information, because that's the name of the game. On a panel, oftentimes African Americans are not going to be selected for projects. People often look out for themselves, and large-scale budgets have a tendency to escape African American artists by plan. So if it's a $1 million project, oftentimes the persons initiating the project have in mind certain individuals, and where if it's a smaller project, then they have a tendency to open the doors to African American artists. So that's something that has to be dealt with. There's also something called cultural equity, in that there are some states who run public art programs that think that the images of African Americans shouldn't be shown in public. That as long as the images are abstract or something like that, then they don't mind that. So there are all kinds of issues other than the technical aspect of simply knowing how to deal with materials and working on a large scale. All these are competitions. I'll compete against 300 or 400 artists nationwide for these contracts. Well, what is 4 hours? 4 hours is nothing. If you're an art student, you're expected to put in hours and hours of work. You don't have the luxury of knowing everything that's on TV, shopping till you're dropping all that stuff. You're a different animal. This is a time-consuming process. It's often very lonely. I work by myself. I can't tell you what's on TV. I'm always asking my wife, where'd you learn? Where'd you hear that song at? I don't hear the music. And if you don't love doing that, it's work now. A lot of it's not fun. A lot of it's labor. If you don't love doing that, you need to do something else. Because this is the only thing that I ever wanted to do. Constantly working with engineers, designers, in doing the piece. I had to be in Florida doing a concrete pedestal. And here you see the anchors, and we've embedded stainless steel in the concrete pedestal because I'm on a schedule. And so I have to be able to plan. Planning is critical when you are doing work on the deadline and contract. Remember at the time, the commission was $25,000, and I was, this is like 27 years ago, and I thought it was a lot of money. I remember thinking, boy, I'm gonna be wealthy. And I recall doing the project, by the time I finished, the project cost me about $20,000 to do. And so it was my first learning. I call this my PhD program as an artist, because I learned so much.
Society that we all belong to. If you're seeking a public commission, The most important thing that you can do is to come up with the best possible presentation. You need to knock people over, you know, with how wonderful it is and what a good presentation it is. And I'll give you a good example of Sam Gilliam, for instance, who happens to be one of my best friends. Sam's presentations are so professional and so incredible and wonderful color, and obviously Sam has, you know, great resources, so he can afford to do a better commission, I mean a better proposal, say, than you all if you happen to be competing with him. So knowing that, going into it, you want it to be clean, you want it to be bright, you want it to be efficient, you want to make sure that the materials that you're using are state-of-the-art materials, which means that the newest and best thing out.
Once it dries, you see all these pores.
So how many layers, how long did this take you?
Exciting, what would happen is the whole town or most possibly culture would get behind us. This is what art was supposed to be about. That we had an image out there that everybody said, yeah, that's us. That's us in the 20th century. That's us now. Whereas, you know, statues of generals with naked women at their feet, it's not my idea of an image that is cool, you know. So I came to D.C. hoping to change that, hoping to put some modern stuff up there that was more meaningful to us. And even though I probably would be outdated in 10 years, at least for a while, we'd have something that was meaningful. When you get into this, they're very rigid. They want usually 10 to 12 slides. They want them numbered. Everyone in my competitions has a different configuration that the slides need to be. Oh, a dot in the left-hand corner, red dot left-hand corner. This one. So half your slides are ruined. Every time you do it, they're ruined. You go, oh, throw that one out. And you go to new kind, and now they want it on the right-hand side. But there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to go ahead and give it to them as clean and neat as you can. And so what are you going to show? They love to see that you have three big commissions up there already and that you're already a big-time sculptor because they can believe in you. I don't know if anybody who's caught a commission like that just showed maquettes. You got to some way start to get something out there. I don't care if you build it yourself. And I even had to take heaters down to that were finished down to someplace to shoot them. And I'd take them in the back of my truck. And one time we snuck down to the Smithsonian and we pulled out one of these, about 8 foot figure I had right in front of the Smithsonian. We jumped out of the car and we put it in there. He's clicking black and white. And I'm picking color. And the guards come out and say, oh, you can't do this. Get the cop comes to get the cameras. And the cops came to the cameras. I said, hey, man, I just want to shot. I said, oh. I started and I got my first commission of my 6 foot fountain from an architect who knew me, saw me, and liked my work. So you got to say that probably it has to do with some connections. You know, you need some of those connections. You need to keep working at a small level, get out to a gallery, some to your friends, enter some art competitions that are looking for small pieces, you know. You win a couple of those go on your resume. You know, all I can say is it's taken me 40 years to get to this success, so you're going to have a lot of drive and have to stay with it, you know. It's going to be a long process. You never know where that break is going to come. But if you stay with it and keep growing, you keep doing it, I'm pretty sure that the breaks will come. I don't guarantee that. So many hours per minute. Oh, I hate it. It's good, man. It's good for what you can do. I go back to work because it's 20 years old. Yeah, I see what I was trying to do. It's good. That's all right. I'm learning more now. It's, you know, don't be too hard on yourself. It's a learning experience.